Oh God, I'm having such a great time. I think we have a real connection.
What? Okay, we just sat down. That is literally the first thing you said to me.
I'm sorry. I just tend to fall in love so quickly.
Oh, that's okay.
Really?
Yeah, I mean, I get it. We all have our thing. I'm sure you eventually get past it, right? So, what do you do for a living?
Wow.
Yep.
Thanks for being so understanding.
I think I heard the bell for the...
What? I didn't hear the bell.
I should go.
Hi, Deborah.
hey there. Greg, right?
Yeah, that's me.
We've been getting some complaints from the other customers here. Oh, okay.
Like what?
Well, the women have said that they sit down and you stare longingly into their eyes or you try to kiss them within a few seconds.
I'm real sorry, man. I just have this tendency to fall in love, like, right away. I just feel these connections.
Man, just take it easy, cool it down, and I bet you one of these women will feel the same way about you. Just give them a chance.
Thanks, man. No one's ever given me such great advice before.
Hey, you're gonna do fine, alright? No complaint, you are out of here.
Hi, I'm Susan.
Hi, I'm Greg.
Nice to meet you. Why are your eyes closed?
Okay. I know this sounds dumb, but I don't want to immediately fall in love with you and get kicked out of the event.
What?
Yeah.
That's like the sweetest thing that anyone's ever said.
Hi.
You know what? No, I can't.
I can't.
I'm sorry. But I know you're not supposed to do these things, but Susan's the only one that stayed with me through the entire allotted time. And look, maybe we both fall in love really easily. Maybe whatever we have isn't meant to last forever, but call me crazy. I want to give this a shot.
Wow. That was an incredible speech.
Every fucking one of these events.
I am a blue car. The blue car is solid and good.
Hey, the red car. The red car is passionate and free.
I am a blue car. The blue car is solid and safe.
I'm a red car. The red car is sexy and
Red.
Blue cars are known for their qualities of friendship.
Red cars are known for their hand jobs.
Blue cars are adept at caring for children.
Red cars are adept at hand jobs.
I shall write a song called Song Song Blue Car.
I'll write a song called Little Red Corvette. It's autobiographical.
I will write a book called One Fish, Two Fish, Red Fish, Blue Car.
I'll write a similar book called One Fish, Two Fish, Red Fish, Hand Job.
I will write a movie called Blue Jasmine. But Jasmine will be a car that is blue.
I'll write a movie called The Hunt for Red October. But October will be a hand job.
Red cars are known for being bitchy and crude.
Blue cars are known for being virgins.
I'm sick of you, red car.
I'm sick of you, blue car.
I'm sick of you, red car.
I'm sick of you, blue car.
I'm sick of you, red car.
Blue car. We we made a decision.
Yes. I think I'm gonna go for the blue car.
Yes!
What made you decide?
Well, this may sound a little crazy, but I think the red car might be a little too slutty for me. Does that make any sense?
Kind of.
Let's go, blue car!
Hey, you're gonna have to pay for that, you know.
Oh yeah, no problem.
Okay, I'll take that money. Great, thanks. Well, well, well. Looks like it's just you and me, red car. I know what comes next.
Hand job!
Presenting the Sleep Number Money Pile.
Ooh,
wow.
Each side of the Sleep Number Money Pile contains an assortment of large and small unmarked bills to adjust to your comfort level. How does it work, you might ask? Well, it's science. Sleep Number Money Pile science.
Huh. I'm setting my side to 85.
I'm setting mine to 50.
Great. Now that is the comfort I dreamed of when I shoved a revolver in that elderly bank teller's face!
But what if you want to read about the police attempts to catch you while you're lying in bed?
Well, we'd have to take some of the money and arrange it in a special pile to lean against while sitting up, huh?
Not anymore.
Wow!
And just watch this glass of wine. One side of the money pile, while on the other side, somebody jumps for joy over the thought of living a sweet life in a non-extradition paradise.
The glass of wine is unshakable, just like us when we shot on the joints of the bank manager to make him open the safe.
Oh. Wow, we're convinced.
The Sleep Number Money Pile. Your final rest may be in a pool of your own blood as you go down in a blaze of glory during a police shootout, but until then, why not rest on the Sleep Number Money Pile?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's the theme of this place. Everything's really tiny. It's the latest trend in fine dining.
Oh, man. How did you even get reservations? This is like the hottest new restaurant.
I've got connections.
Oh, I am impressed.
What should I do? I was setting up the set, and they drew the lights on, and now I'm stuck on stage.
Just get off stage.
It's too late. You already introduced the premise.
It's cool. Just get out of here, man.
It's easy for you to say. This is the first sketch I wrote. My first sketch, so I'm not ruining it by getting off stage in the middle.
You're already ruining it! Just go!
I'm gonna be a lamp.
No! Don't be a lamp! Don't be a lamp!
I'm a lamp.
Sorry about that broken lamp. Let the waiter take care of that. I want everything to be perfect for our second date.
Oh, you're so romantic.
Hi, have we had a chance to look over the menu?
Oh, I should have pretended to be a waiter.
Are you doing on stage?
Oh, there'll be two waiters at one table. That's actually a funny sketch idea. Right, Tony?
No, just go!
Sorry about that. Former disgruntled employee. So we have some specials tonight. We have tiny rack of lamb, tiny fillet of sole, and a baby shrimp platter. All the time.
They all sound so good!
Shall I give you a tiny amount of time to think it over?
Sure.
Okay.
So, what do you think about it?
I'm going back and forth between the large mouth, small body bass, bass, and the tiny, tiny layers.
Here's a small suggestion. Why don't we split it?
I'll get a tiny bit into that.
Hello, I'm your second waiter.
What are you doing?
The first waiter messed up one of the lines. She was supposed to be like,
would you like a teeny bit amount of time to think this over? Are you ready?
Yeah, it just happens sometimes in live. You just improvise and keep going, okay? I'm sorry, I didn't know that. Dude, it's my first sketch thing.
Oh, look, it's your first waiter. Well, a restaurant with two waiters and one table? That's crazy.
What the hell are you doing?
Sorry about that. Yes, we're overstaffed tonight. So here's a tiny amuse bouche for you to share. Compliments of the chef.
It's super hard to taste, but I think it's delicious.
Hello, Fantastic Four. These are Dr. Doom, and I'm here to fuck up New York City.
Not if we have anything to say about it. Let me introduce the team. Ben's got super strength, his power beyond compare. Johnny controls the fire, mankind's greatest tool.
Flame on!
I can stretch and bend my body at will. I'm in control of my very molecules.
And what about her?
Huh? Oh, yeah, Susan. Come on, sweetheart, tell Dr. Doom what your power is. Show him.
She disappeared!
Isn't that cute?
Prepare to fight! Wait, hold on. Your group's only woman has the power to make herself up.